Organised by the Bugatti Owners Club, the May meeting at Prescott is the first round of the 1959 Hill Climb Championship. Ashley Cleave talks horsepower with championship favourite David Boshier Jones. Phil Scragg, his interests are sports cars and textile machinery. This is the sports car. Fine weather for practice, but this was to change all too soon. There are no formula restrictions on hill climb cars, and George Keelock tries a supercharger on his Cooper Climax. The 500 comes to the line. David Boshier Jones, destined to become hill climb champion for 1959, takes his Cooper twin off the line for late practice. The rain in Spain stays mainly on the plain, but in this country it seems to favour the hills. But Jennings stays dry in his Renault Gordini. Tony Marsh, former hill climb champion, brings his Lotus single-seater out onto a very damp starting area. Prescott is 880 yards long, with a tricky mixture of hairpin bends and short straights. Marsh takes the Lotus up to Pardon Hairpin. There is no room for mistakes, and a missed gear change can cost you fastest time of the day. And he's missed one, but he's back in gear. David Good gives the time-honored sign to indicate that the car is firing on two cylinders. ...1959 was to see David claim second place in the championship with a series of magnificently judged climbs. This climb by David Boshier Jones was the fastest ever in the wet at Prescott, and also gave him fastest time of the day. A great climb. Tommy Norton in the blown Cooper is very neat round Orchard Bend. And that's Tony Marsh playing in the sand. Patsy Burt demonstrates an entirely new technique. She is unharmed except for a little dented pride. And the Prescott Mountain Rescue Team spring into action. Pauline Brock decides to stick to the old route. Reg Phillips in the Fairly Climax. The engine is mounted transversely across the frame and it's supercharged. ERAs have for long been a feature of hill climbing. Twin rear wheels give you a little better chance in the wet. And so a damp Prescott comes to an end, and the Lotus drivers prepare their all-weather equipment for the drive home.